Throughout NBA history, we've witnessed a plethora of flat-out embarrassing losses. Losses that the losing team would want nothing more than to forget about. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at a particular loss that was so bad, I could barely even find highlights of the game. It looks like they wanted the footage to be buried. And I can't really blame them. The way they lost was not pretty at all. It was Halloween night, 2006. The Miami Heat was just a few months removed from their impressive championship run. In fact, their first round opponent of that postseason, the Chicago Bulls, was also their opponent for this game. That 2006 playoff series these two teams had a few months earlier was a good one. The Bulls gave the Heat some real problems throughout the course of the series, but ultimately Miami would come out on top in 6 games. So you know, Chicago couldn't wait to get their hands on them again. And did I mention that this was opening night? Which meant that Miami received their championship rings before the game? They had this huge ceremony, celebrating what they accomplished. There was a banner presentation, an infinite amount of pictures, and they even showed highlights of their postseason run on the giant screen as well, further rubbing it in the Bulls' face. Everything was perfect. They were finally validated as champions. Dwayne Wade had a lot to feel good about.
Omar, perhaps no NBA player was busier in the offseason than Dwayne Wade. After being named the MVP of the finals, there he was at MTV with Adam Sandler. He was hosting a benefit bowling tournament. Then he was on the cover of virtually every magazine, including GQ, who named him the best dressed in the NBA. And tonight he's not only wearing a new ring, but wearing a new shoe.
The Miami Heat was on top of the world, but all of those pre-game distractions had them completely unprepared for the onslaught that was coming. As the game got underway, both teams were just trying to get in the rhythm of things. D-Wade had some early buckets to get the blood going, but when the second quarter came along, the Bulls took off and never looked back. As the night went on, the lead just kept growing bigger and bigger. It was unbelievable what was happening. You would think that the defending champs would put up a better fight than that. I mean, if you were to take some random guys on the street who never even watched basketball before and show them this game, they would hardly believe it if you told them this team were that year's champion. Miami was not into it at all. It was clear the energy and motivation was not there. The Heat were just jogging around, while the Bulls destroyed them in transition. They made it a mission to attack Shaq all night long, which got him into foul trouble, and ended the night with only 7 points. Although D-Wade was able to score the ball, it was visibly clear that he was frustrated about how the game was going. All in all, it was just the Bulls' night. Their new addition, Ben Wallace, definitely made a difference. And they even had the better bench. In fact, they actually had to break Tyrus Thomas's nose because they couldn't seem to slow the rookie down. They were absolutely blindsided by Chicago's maximum effort. You could say that Miami was possibly exhausted from just playing in the finals, but even their fans were waving the white flag. If they were not able to stick around for a finals game, you know they weren't gonna put up with this garbage, as Kirk Heinrich and the Bulls spoiled their party, winning by 42 points.
And that will wrap it. It's the fewest points Miami has ever scored against Chicago. And we're hearing boos from this crowd. I thought they were very compassionate.
Alonzo Mourning was completely shocked by what went down and gave us this famous meme. The Heat might have went home with the shiny rings, but this was by far the worst loss in NBA history for a defending champion on opening night. This loss was so devastating, it had a lasting effect through that 06-07 Miami Heat season. And fittingly, in that year's playoffs, they would actually be swept by none other than the Chicago Bulls in the first round, and it seemed like it took them many years to recover. Remember, Chicago were also the ones who put an end to Miami's 27-game winning streak in 2013, but I'm sure if you asked D-Wade, he would agree that this one was way more humiliating. 2006 Halloween was a total nightmare and quite the scare to start off the NBA season. Alright, I wanted to make sure I get something out for you guys on Halloween, and with this game taking place on the same date 14 years ago, I thought this story would be a nice little treat. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.